Alright, so let's look at question 10 of the tutorial. Here we're asked to calculate the change in molar Gibbs energy of a perfect gas when its pressure is increased isothermally from 50 kph to 100 kph at a specific temperature. Of course, it's done isothermally, so that is the temperature. And basically, this is a straightforward application of the equation, which is... I'm the wrong color, as always, you know, can't start off the question correctly. So the straightforward application of this equation, so basically just that the molar Gibbs energy at some pressure is equal to the molar Gibbs energy at another pressure plus RT ln of the final pressure over the initial pressure. So a straightforward application of that one. So of course, if we take this over to that side, then we get that, so GM PF minus GM PI, which is of course delta GM. And then that would be equal to RT ln of PF over PI. You know, we write PF over PI, TF over TI, VF over VI. One would think we have developed some sort of notation for that by now, but we haven't yet. So anyway, maybe I should develop a notation for that. But that would just confuse you once again. So anyway. So, ln PF over PI, and now I can't scroll anymore, so we just plug in the values 8.3145, of course this is as always joule per Kelvin per mole. The temperature is 500 Kelvin. And we just plug in the ln values. So final pressure is 100 kph, oh, kilopascals, kph, wow, what? Over 50 kilopascals, kPa, which should give a value of approximately 2.88 something times 10 to the power 3 joule per mole. Which you can then round off to. We have three significant figures, 50 kPa and 500 Kelvin, so 2.88 kilojoule per mole. Alright, so a very easy application. Just to show you that there is some application to that derivation that we did in the notes. This equation. Alright. I think, well, that was the final question of the tutorial. So, just a very straightforward application of the equation. Basically, giving you... what is the molar, what's the change in molar Gibbs energy? So of course, what is the interpretation? Does this imply a spontaneous change or not? Molar Gibbs energy, of course, this means this change is larger than zero. Gibbs energy needs to be negative for a change to be spontaneous. So it means at this temperature, this will not occur spontaneously. So in other words, you need to do something for this to actually be happen. You will have to do some work for this to occur. Interesting facts. In other words, you know, if this is the process that you would want to do, then you will have to do something, which might be a follow-up question that I might ask you, some interpretation of what this actually means. If this were negative, then of course it means it will occur spontaneously. So of course the opposite of this process will be spontaneous, you know. The compression of this gas at this temperature will be spontaneous. Right. That is it. Can you believe it? Something that simple. But yet, there's still some interesting interpretation of it and discussion that can take place.